Thank you very much. You can see that for this region post-COVID, although other parts of the world are still in the middle of it, that we have seen a clear recovery of economic activity, increased trade flows. The Middle East and the Gulf is benefiting from a central logistical and transport distribution point of view. You also see that the tourism has increased again. UAE is a big example of that, for example. Thirdly, I would say that the oil price is obviously at a much better level. So for UAE, but especially for Saudi, you can see, I think Aramco is now the most profitable company in the world, for example. And you see also positive effects in other countries where the oil price will benefit. Fourthly, I would say that these increased revenues and profitability have then the opportunity for these countries to diversify their economies in new investments. For example, in Saudi, we can see a lot of investment in the tourism area and, for example, NEOM, the new big city, but also investments in green energy and new infrastructure, real estate developments. So overall, you can see a lot of positive momentum in the Gulf. Interest rates are historically at a low, so even a small increase in the curve of the underlying interest rate will not have a huge impact. The market is still extremely liquid. There's a lot of opportunities for corporates and other institutions to raise debt, either in the loan market or in the bond market or other markets. Deutsche Bank is very active to advise clients on opportunities in those markets. And what we see is that the underlying credit quality of our clients and of the wider market is still good, because the credit spread is the other variable in the calculation of an interest rate that someone would need to pay. But I think for both, I don't see a lot of refinancing risk in the next 12 to 18 months. As the market is liquid and the rise is relatively historically still a low rise. So obviously if clients, corporates have a view that interest rates will rise significantly, they have the option to lock in the lower interest rate today, something that we as Deutsche Bank are very active in advising. Secondly, again, I think for these specific sectors, there are other challenges that they might have in oil and gas that we can talk about later. But on the interest rate itself, if they are concerned about rising interest rates, then there are ways to hedge that risk already now. So we see in the region indeed many mega projects where they are diversifying away from, let's say, oil and gas. And what we do is, especially with cross-border projects, where, for example, large exporters from America, Europe or Asia participate in these projects, that we can offer very good structured financing, and that is something that is very much appreciated by the clients here in the Gulf. You see that the local banks are also in Saudi and the UAE are very keen to participate. So there's a lot of liquidity. Where the foreign banks like Deutsche Bank come in is where it's more structured and where the relationship with the exporters is very important. So usually we have two clients working on both sides on these mega projects, which makes it highly viable and doable. Yeah, so in supporting those clients with the projects, we have the investment banking angle, also with merchant acquisitions, with joint ventures that are being formed. We see companies wanting to go to the stock exchange in Saudi, in UAE, Abu Dhabi, Dubai, where we can advise them what it will bring in terms of additional exposure, growth opportunities to finance these mega projects, and also on the financing side, bring in expertise to make sure that these mega projects will actually have a viable start and be able to be executed in the long run. So it's something we are very active in and we are very focused on. So Deutsche Bank has defined last year a sustainability strategy globally, which means that we as a bank ourselves will become more sustainable, but also our advice and execution towards clients will become more sustainable. That means that we have communicated clear commitments to the market, like 200 billion euros of financing for this ESG initiative. What we also see is that we have a clear taxonomy internally what qualifies as ESG and what not. And we advise our clients on their journey in terms of what they would need to do to become more ESG, but also how to finance that. For example, we have done the first green bond in Egypt. We have done the first green repo here in the UAE. And from that perspective, we are very active. We advise, we have the capabilities, and the E on the environmental, very strong, but also the S, we can do a lot on that front as well. So from that perspective, we are here, we are advising, we're very active, and we are the first in many instances as well with execution.